Okay, here we go. Okay, great. Well, listen, thank you so much for being here with me this evening. What I want to talk to you about is the middle class millionaire survival and thrival plan. We want not just to survive, we want to thrive, but there's, I'm going to share with you, everybody in here with us tonight could be not just an agent, some are agents, some are not. You know, there are. When I wrote this book, The Middle Class Millionaire Plan, I wrote it for both. I wrote it for people who would become clients as well as agents. And the reason I did that was because I think that a client and an agent, or financial concierge, as I like to call them, should share the same principles. They should have the same mindset. They should be looking to accomplish the identical things. There's no I win, you lose. It's not just a win-win, but it's a relationship where if I'm going to become financially independent as a financial concierge, then everyone I work with individually or in groups, everyone I work with and trying to help them become financially independent, we should all become financially independent together. So hopefully that makes sense. So what we did is put some tools together in that selection and built a lot of white papers. Some of you are familiar with those. The white papers, the three golden rules of financial independence. They had the law of multiplicity in there about being open-minded. We talked about money in 3D. Money is a living, actual, thriving kind of source, not just something sitting in a piece of paper in your pocket. So when I started Advocacy Network, it was about one thing. Your best interest is our only concern, and we are your advocate. Now, that was begun to eliminate all forms of financial victimization, which in and of itself is a friendlier conversation to have with a potential client. It's non-threatening. It goes right to the heart and source of something they may have already experienced, or certainly someone in their family, friends, or someone in their circles has experienced being scammed, defrauded, or making a serious mistake with money. Let's face it, most of the agents I speak with, myself, I've made almost every mistake you can make with money. I've fallen victim to several scams. So it can happen to anyone at any time if they're not familiar with the red flags and the things they need to know. So to date, and I started this back in 2010, we have actually probably had contact and served over 12,000 people. We're now up to $15 million. Those are $15 million that would have been lost in some form of scam, fraud, or some financial victimization, which quite a bit of it was in bad annuities or bad advice from annuities. And I can't tell you how much bad advice is out there. You know, we live in this society now talking about social media, and everybody's talking about how much misinformation there is, and you know what I mean, and false news and all of this. Well, for well over 50 years, the financial services industry has been telling some real whoppers. There's been some really serious lies going on and some serious misinformation. Some of it you can't help but say is intentional. Some of it you could just tag on to incompetence, but a good deal of it is intentional. And that's what I'm looking to really fight, okay? We live in the richest nation in the world. I don't think there's any argument to that. But at the same time, we have the highest rate of financial illiteracy. And really, people are in one of four stages. Most of the people you meet and I meet and we talk to are unaware, meaning they don't know what they don't know. It's impossible for you to know something that you don't know because you're not even aware that you don't know it. Okay. And then with confirmation bias and all kinds of personal biases, you tend to latch on to people who you feel are authorities and they're more aware, and you tend to trust what they say. I won't name them. You know the gurus on the radio. You know the gurus in the magazines. You know the financial media talking heads, all passing out very bad information. Okay, very bad information. So once you become aware there's something you don't know, you now are aware that you don't know it. Awareness means you actually try to use and get familiar with what it is you didn't know. And wisdom is the ability to help others with this awareness and at the same time be very, very cognizant when you're getting or being elicited through bad information. So the solution to this was to get more education out there into the masses and speak to people. So what is it I want to do? Well, pre-pandemic, I had written this book, The Middle Class Millionaire Plan, and I had really wanted to go on this crusade. This is truly a mission for all of you who are listening to me and hear this. This is a mission. I'm looking for people who want to help other people one by one, can do it in groups. But now that we've got the power of virtual, we can reach far more people much faster, much sooner. But I think we got to have a message that helps them understand, were you aware of this? And that's really where these other things come into play, okay? Now, I built a marketing funnel. So at theadvocacynet.com, people can just sign up, register, and get the book. Now, I think as a professional, the first goal is to get them to read the book. Now, people won't read a whole book. I understand that. But if they'll scroll through and the book was written, it's not that many. I think it's 65 pages or less. But the book was written for people to latch on to a couple of key points on how to become financially independent. So if they don't read the whole book, no big deal. They'll pick and choose. But after they get the book, you're able to speak to them to set up a consultation. And that consultation is a simple discovery meeting where you're able to tell them, and ahead of time, you're able to tell them, I have the advocacy network myself. The membership's $195 a year. We've got some real positive stuff on that. It's really a $395 value because I added financial transformation to the membership. So you could tell a person for a consultation, hey, if you'll just meet with me for 30 minutes and listen and share some information, and I can give you some really, really key things you need to know about financial independence, I will give you a complimentary membership to the Advocacy Network, which means, you know, it's $395 value right in your pocket just for spending 30 minutes with me. Non-decision-making meeting, no big deal. I'm going to share some really solid information that's very important. Okay, so that brings us to the thought process of just simple education, okay? We want to create awareness. Inside of that, we're providing some financial literacy education. And most importantly, we want to help people attain financial independence. Now, 95% of our population never attains financial independence. This is going on for over 150 years that only 5% ever reach financial independence. Now, that's disgraceful. But you got to recognize that this is because of a lot of bad information, a big lack of knowledge, and a lot of bad advice because people are manipulative in what advice they give out. They want a bad mouth insurance. They want a bad mouth life insurance, which is the greatest financial tool ever invented. And yet you've got people for differing reasons. They don't want people to learn about the power of life insurance, and thus they never do. Okay, so we've got the financial transformation course, which is part of the membership. It's involved in there. You, everyone I'm speaking to, licensed or unlicensed, or person in the business or not in the business, or even just a person who's becoming a client wanting to become financially independent, the power of you becoming a financial concierge is what's going to drive your financial independence. So we're going to train, coach, develop. We're going to do all that for you. So the idea here is that one person is going to learn, is going to teach, is going to reach out to another person, and then it's going to help them create the income they need to create so that they can solve this financial independence issue. So this is really what we're trying to build here. Okay, so it's a learn, an earn, and a law of multiplicity. Okay, the people who become financially independent all have learned about the law of multiplicity. You need three types of income to become financially independent. This is not a talking point. It's not a suggestion. It's a reality. Without these three types of income, no one reaches financial independence. People who are doctors, lawyers, dentists, in the top 5% of income earners in our nation, they get paid for their direct services, and that's all they ever attain or do. They don't reach financial independence because they never created residual income. They've never even possibly discussed it or even heard of it. And then they certainly have worked to try to create passive income, but because of market risk, they never get the passive income either because they spend too much time losing money in these other passive events. So really, as a financial concierge, that's what we're there for. We want to show people how to build this foundation and create financial independence. So when I look at the opportunity, here's what I'm really talking about. If we show everyone we talk with, what it looks like to put away $1,500 to $2,000 a month to create their own private bank, you're showing them the liquidity. You're showing them the unique asset of life insurance. What is it? It creates tax-free liquidity and income. Now, whatever that purpose is for, it could be long-term, short-term, or mid-term. But at the end of the day, people will understand that this is how you acquire financial independence. Now, the question then becomes, well, I don't have $1,500 a month. I don't have $2,000 a month, $2,500 a month. Of course you don't. I wasn't here saying you did. We are going to show you how to create that income, because your problem is not enough savings. That's not your problem. You got nothing to save. If you had something to save, you'd save it. You don't need to be educated on that. Your problem is not paying down debt or taking on too much debt. That's not your problem, because you certainly would pay it down or stop taking it on if you really wanted to do that. So the issue here now, I'm showing you how to create your own bank. You become your own creditor and your own finance agent. You do these things for yourself instead of doing it for others. That's the deal. Now, where does the income come from? Well, the income is going to come from you learning this, starting to earn, teaching others the same process, the same exact process, one by one. I recently have taken on to a methodology of telling people I only take on one new client a week. That's created an urgency. It somehow has a different connotation when I tell people that. Suddenly, people want to hear what I got to say when I tell them I only take on one new client a week. So those of you who are licensed right now, and those of you who are going to work to get licensed, we're going to be teaching and training all of that. You'd be so surprised about the power of one new client a week. Now, that's only 52 or maybe possibly 60 or 40 clients a year. But you're talking about an average case of between $5,000 and $8,000 in commission. So I don't think you're worried about how many of them you do. So the income creation opportunity is a discussion with people that no one's having, by the way. We're the only ones that'll be telling people you got to increase your income. Now, a direct employee, they're somewhere in that range from $25,000 to $50,000 a year. Of course, there's some six-figure earners and there's some exceptions to the rule, but let's just go with the base median. It's $25,000 to $50,000 a year. Now, a direct business, a person who is a self-employed person, they're somewhere between $50,000 to $100,000, many of them as much as $250,000 and $350,000 a year, depending on what kind of business they've created and what they've done. So they are really represent the mass affluent. But that three types of income entrepreneur is always a six-figure earner. Not sometimes, they're always a six-figure earner, okay? So anyone can create more income. We just need to help people establish a strategy on how to save that increased income, where to put it, how to make it residual, how to make it passive. And that is how we create financial independence. And guess what? The first tool in the tool bag, the biggest tool is the life insurance policy. It is the thing that kicks off everything else. Too few people know this. Too many people badmouth it. And way too many people advise against it because it's not in their own best interest for their business. So I'm looking to help everybody with a simple shift in mindset. I want you to think in terms of creation with an entrepreneurial spirit, and you basically have no competition, okay? Fully independent. We want people to be complete control, full accountability. got a desire to help others and pay it forward. This is truly a pay it forward system, okay? So an abundant mindset, not a scarcity-driven mindset. An abundant mindset sees opportunities and recognizes things others don't. An abundant mindset knows that there's plenty to go around. Look, we got 300 million people in this country, and we take away the children. I think we still got 280. But we've got all these people, 95% who never reach financial independence, they're struggling. They're out there, they're scared. It's $5 a gallon for gas. It's the food bill has gone up 30%. These people they didn't have savings to begin with. And the ones who do have some savings are now going through it like crazy. They need to be shown how to increase their income. And we can certainly do it. Okay, now I'm not going to be able to help the entire population. We know this. But if each one of us is helping 50 people a year, 60 people a year, we've got a really, really magnificent organization. Okay, I take on one new client a week, man, create the sense of urgency as an authority. And what are you going to show them? Well, we're going to build all that in. It's very simple procedure. I'm going to show you, I'm not going to go through the whole thing, but I'm going to show you before we stop. I'm going to show you a simple presentation. I'm not going to make the whole presentation. I'm just going to show you the flash through the 8 slides so you know. I will teach and coach everyone that comes through here exactly how to get this conversation started and to how to expand this conversation and how to solve the problem at the end. The people we've worked with to date, we got 100% track record on making people financially independent. Everyone wins when we do what we do, okay? So we simply got to work on changing the way we think ourselves, not just the people around us, okay? Keep doing what you're doing and you're going to keep getting the same results. Change is good. Learning is an everyday thing. Gaining and growing in confidence is going to come with knowledge. The more you know, the more you're able to have this conversation and spread this narrative and story, the more confident you're going to become and you're going to master it. That's going to lead to independence. You're going to be financially independent yourself. You're not going to have to be going around looking for, oh, who's going to get leads? Who's the best lead generator? How much money do I have to pay for this program? What do I got to pay for that program? You know, let's stop looking for the magic silver bullets and realize sitting right in front of us is acres of diamonds, acres of diamonds. Every single person that we come across has this problem. This is a universal problem. Whether they're wealthy or they are just middle class and the low end of middle class. Now, there's not much we can do for poor. Although we can still give the message to the poor, they can still increase their income. They can still do some things. Now, they may not be clients immediately. They may not be able to come on to clients, but we can still teach them the mindset. But from the middle class to the wealthy, this is all there, okay? So we've helped people in the book with the middle class mind, millionaire plan, to know thyself, beliefs and values. What do they believe about money? The behaviors and the results. How have they treated their money to date? What has been the results? And why have they continually gotten those results? Do they need to make some adjustments and some shifts? Yes, they do. We know that. So as a financial concierge, you are the answer. You're an accountability partner. You're a coach. You've got the power of the mastermind. You can pay it forward. And all we got to know is that we are in a cycle to learn, to earn, to teach, and to reach out to people. That's what we do. So, and I'm going to give you a few little ideas because we know that there are some problems that everyone seemed to have. And I will touch that real quickly after, right? But just remember that the members of the advocacy network, they're never victims. We don't have victims. The members are free of victimhood. Okay. The financial concierge is your partner. You need that partner. The common goal for the financial concierge and the individual is financial independence. That is a transformative event. The book is the key to getting people out there first. And basically, we've got all kinds of networks of third-party endorsed professionals. So we've got a solution and an answer for anybody. I'm not going to go through this part of it. That's for another time. So I'm going to bring us up to one more screen share real quick. And I'm going to show you briefly, very briefly, what the little presentation is about. Not so much, you know, how would you do it or any of that. I just want you to see a real easy presentation. Okay. So let me see if I get to the slideshow here. Okay, resume live. Oh no, I'm sorry. That's the wrong button. Yep, they try to make it easy, huh? Yes, sir. Make it easy. Share the screen. Here we go. All righty. You should be seeing a middle-class millionaire plan, hopefully, right? And let me move this. Let me start a slideshow. This slideshow. Okay, from the beginning. Here we go. Okay. All right. So again, we got the book. We've got the consultation where we could give away the free membership. Those are all tools. Those are all marketing tools. We've got other things. We got all kinds of stuff. Okay. We got more stuff than you could possibly shake a stick at. We can give more value added to people just to sit down and listen to something, by the way, that is going to enhance their lives tremendously. I've got some very important information to share with you. Well worth your time. You don't even have to make a decision on it. Just let me share with you to see if you're aware of these things. That's it. Okay? And I want to show you how to become financially independent. All right. So in this presentation, we started talking a little bit about how the ERISA, the Employee Retirement Income Security Act, how that has come about, why it's come about. Of course, you will find out if a person is in a 401k, do they have a pension plan? Because maybe they have that asset. If they do, we got something to discuss immediately. If they don't, not a problem. We're going to go into other things, okay? So basically, we just showed people the U.S. debt versus qualified funds. You know, if you want to have a partner, think about it. Your partner, if you're talking to people about their 401ks, this is a wide open. Right now, there's about $27 trillion in total pensions. I think about $22 trillion in 401ks. That's a lot of money to be helping people move into financial independence, okay? And it's so simple because most people have no clue that their 401k is going to increase their Medicare premium. It's going to reduce their Social Security check. It's going to create a lot of problems for them, okay? Their money's going to constantly be exposed to a market risk. Their money's totally illiquid until retirement, okay? And on top of that, a penalty, all right? The more income they create, the higher the taxation. So they're going to pay the highest possible tax bill they could ever pay. And presently, on the way, they're paying the highest commissions and fees possible. So to really summarize it, when you talk to someone, when they have a 401k partnership is what they have with the government under ERISA, well, here's your partnership. You put up all the money, you take all the risk, and when you die, retire, or you need money, your partner steps in and they declare their share of the spoils, which they can actually confiscate under law if you're not willing to give them their share. And lastly, when your partner determines their share, you have no say in the matter. So believe me, I don't think it's hard to tell people how egregious it is that their 401k plan is not going to do what they were promised that it was going to do. And we certainly have the answer. Okay, and it's like I say down there, wouldn't you break a partnership with a drunken sailor? I think I would. If I was in business with a drunken sailor, they just wouldn't give up. I think I would get rid of them. But when you take that 401k out, you're taking on a partner who's got $30 trillion in debt. Now, I don't know about you, but I ain't too fond of having a partner $30 trillion in debt who's doing nothing for me. So really, it's not a hard story, okay? Tax deduction, we get a chance to talk about the myth of the tax deduction and the so-called tax-free growth. In life insurance, you have all that. You don't have a deduction, but you don't need the deduction. In life insurance, you have the tax-deferred growth, full liquidity anytime you want it, anytime you need it. And at the back end of it, it's all tax-free income. And liquidity is tax-free, by the way, whenever you use it. And you have a second type of liquidity in life insurance, which no one seems to talk about. If you become critically ill, if you become chronically ill, or if you become terminally ill, there's a whole nother pool of liquidity for you to tap into at that point in life to help you, your family, and anybody else involved in these financial difficulties. You can't do that with anything else. There's nothing else in the world that'll do that. Only life insurance. Okay, so really, when people have the 401k or the retirement money they're putting away, the IRA, whatever, we got something to talk to them about. We got a serious alternative for them to a solution. But we don't have to have that because the conversation is about increasing income. Okay. And basically, it's a simple process. Okay. All we're going to do is consult. And when you consult with people, you're going to identify all their assets and their structures. That early conversation is going to be, do you have a 401k? Are you participating presently in a 401k? Do you have equity in your home? What does that look like? That's the only thing you need to know. You don't need to know their debts. You don't need to know who they owe money to. You don't need to know how much money they got coming in. You don't need to know any of that. All you need to know is that they need to increase their income. And do they have present assets that we can presently use to diversify, correlate, and maybe transfer in another direction? Okay. Step three, you're going to show them how to establish their personal bank. And then you're going to have your ongoing annual reviews to make sure this thing is working. By the way, if they don't have any of the assets, you're going to put them in a term insurance policy to build their bank. Now, they're getting nothing from that, but they're protecting their future insurability, and they built the foundation for their bank. It's like if you were going to build a bank and you had this building, what would you do in the foundation? You'd have to build a foundation. So presently, because you don't have the income, because you're not ready to start putting this into your bank presently, we need to set up enough term insurance for you to have that ability to convert it. Okay. So all I'm saying to everybody is we're talking to people totally counterintuitive. We want people to have an open mind to what we're saying. We're talking about positive change in creating financial independence and making people understand that nothing's going to change unless they do. Now, will this take a little bit of coaching and training? Sure. But everybody I speak to is capable of doing this. I have yet to meet anyone who's incapable of this. In fact, many of the people I talk to already seem to understand a lot of these principles, but they haven't yet seemed to connect them. They haven't put the jigsaw puzzle all together. They just got loose pieces. Look, as an organization, I'm saying we create and fill the jigsaw puzzle. We are going to show people how to reach financial independence. It doesn't have to be any more complicated than that. It's not a complex issue. It's not rocket science. And yes, you just need to know which piece goes where in the puzzle. And when you fit the right pieces into the puzzle, you've helped somebody create financial independence. So with that, I'm going to shut down. Don't go anywhere. I'm just going to shut down the recording and we can have a question and answer. So everyone, hopefully this helped everybody. Hopefully you'll take a look at this and go to theadvocacynet.com, theadvocacynet.com, and get the book. Get the book. Read the book before anything else. Just read the book, and we can always talk about the principles and how to go forward.